This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to calculate the growth rate for an investment. Here's our problem. It says, an investment of $4,000 grows to $6,800 in 10 years. What annual nominal rate would produce the same growth if the interest was compounded annually, or compounded monthly, or compounded continuously? Okay, let's start with the compounded annually part of the problem. We want to find out what the interest rate would have to be if we took $4,000, compounded it annually for 10 years, and wanted it to grow to $6,800. So the formula we have for compounded interest is A equals P times 1 plus r over n raised to the nt power. Now, A is the amount of money that we're getting back. We want to get back $6,800. So we can fill in that, 6,800. And P is the principal, which is the $4,000 we would invest initially. Then we've got 1 plus r over n. R is the interest rate. We don't know that, so we'll use an R. And N is the number of compounding periods a year. Well, if it's compounded annually, there's only one compounding period each year. So N would be 1. So we'll just leave this as 1 plus R. And then we're raising that to the NT power. Well, T is time, and we want this to happen over a 10-year period. N, once again, equals 1, so we'll just raise this to the 10th power. Okay, now what we have to do is solve for R. The first thing I'll do is divide both sides of the equation by 4,000. So I've got 6,800 divided by 4,000. When I do that addition, I end up with 1.7. And that 1.7 equals 1 plus r raised to the 10th power. So I'd like to get rid of this exponent, the 10. What I'll do is I'll raise the entire right side of the equation to another power, 1 over 10. And then the 10 and the 1 over 10 will cancel each other out. I have to do the same thing to the left side of the equation. So I'm going to take 1.7 and also raise that to the 1 over 10. This means I'll have 1.7 raised to the 1/10th power, and that will equal, this will just be 1 plus r. And then let's finish getting the r all by itself. I'll just subtract 1 from both sides of the equation. So I have 1.7 raised to the 1 over 10, minus 1 equals r. So now we need a calculator. I want 1.7 raised to the 1 divided by 10. When I get that answer, I want to subtract a 1 from it. And what I end up with is 0.05449. And that equals r. Okay, so we probably want to round this and turn it into a percent. So I'll multiply it by 100. That will give me 5.4, and I'll round it to 5.45%. So the answer to the first part of the problem is we would have to invest this money at 5.45%. Now let's go on to the next part. This is where the money is invested and compounded monthly. So we'll have that same formula again. A equals P times 1 plus R over N raised to the NT power. A, once again, is 6,800. And P is 4,000. We're multiplying that times 1 plus R. We don't know what R is, but N, the number of compounding periods a year, would be 12, because we're compounding it monthly. And then we raise that to the nt power. N is 12, and t is the number of years, that's 10. Okay, so now we want to solve for r. I'll divide both sides by 4,000. When I did that last time, I got 1.7. So I just put in 1.7 equals 1 plus r over 12 raised to the 12 times 10. Well, 12 times 10 is 120. I want to get rid of the exponent, so I'll multiply, I'll raise both sides of the equation to the 1 over 120 as a power. So now I have 1.7 raised to the 1 over 120 equals 1 plus r over 12. I'll subtract a 1 from both sides of the equation. I have 1.7 to the 1 over 120 minus 1 equals r over 12. And to get rid of that 12, I'll just multiply both sides of the equation by 12. So I have 12 times 1.7 raised to the 1 over 120 minus 1 equals r. Okay, time for the calculator again. First, I'll do 1.7 raised to the 1 divided by 120. I'll subtract a 1 from that. And now I want to take that, that's everything here in parentheses, and multiply it by 12. And what I end up with here is 0.05318 for r. We'll turn this into a decimal, into a percentage, and we'll round it. So it's going to be 5. We'll make that 3.2%. So that's the rate. And this is a little bit lower than what we got the last time. The last time was 5.45, which makes sense because we're compounding it more frequently. Okay, the last part is what happens when we compound it continuously. So we've got a different formula for that. The formula for compounded continuously is A equals P times E raised to the RT. So A, once again, is 6,800. P is 4,000. Then I've got E raised to the R. I don't know what R is, but I know that T is 10. So I've got R times 10, or 10R. I want to solve for R. So I'm going to take the natural log of both sides of this equation. That means I'll have ln, oh, I'm sorry, I should have first divided both sides by 4,000, that would have been easier. When I divide by 4,000, that's the same thing I've done twice already, I get 1.7 equals e to the 10r. Now we'll take the natural logs. So we're going to have ln, the natural log of 1.7, equals the natural log of e raised to the 10r. I can take this exponent, the 10r, and using the exponent rule that I have for logarithms, make that into a coefficient. So I have the natural log of 1.7 equals 10r times the natural log of e. But the natural log of e is just 1. So I can cross that out. The natural log of 1.7 equals 10r. I'll just divide both sides by 10. And I get the rate is the natural log of 1.7 divided by 10. Let's use the calculator to find that. I've got the natural log of 1.7. And I want to divide that by 10. And what I get is 0.05306 for the rate. we'll round this and turn it into a percent, it's going to be 5.31%, a little bit lower than the previous rate because we're compounding it continuously. Okay, so that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.